You just got to wake the machine up. It doesn't pick up sound initially. Anyway, here we are, and here we are. Beautiful day. Daffy Down Dillies, it's St. David's Day on Tuesday the 1st. So that's the Welsh, so they have a leek or a daffodil, I think. Yeah. And it's Shrove Tuesday and Ash Wednesday, so there we are. Anyway, here we are, and here we are. Now, so Radio 4 this morning from 7, the news, and then it's a religious affairs program hosted today by Ed Sturton, who's a Roman Catholic but a very good journalist. And, you know, obviously the war in Ukraine, etc. Right, I am a Christian. I'm in St. Albans. As it happens, I've got a total left knee replacement, and it needs revision. So I'm off to the Royal National Orthopaedic Hospital Stanmore tomorrow. So I come down early anyway. Sleeping out again, but it's fine. I'm a Christian, so I'm at home with God. So, right, I've got my own home back up in Alnwick now in Northumbria, which is a blessing. Now, queues of people, okay, they're leaving, right. I'm pretty sure it was Justin Welby, the Archbishop of the Church of England, he was interviewing, and others. And here's St. Alban, right? So he was a Roman centurion in charge of 100 troops or whatever, obviously involved in suppressing the local citizens if ordered so to do, and killing them, no doubt. He saw the light of Christ and said no to killing, to the point that he was prepared to be martyred. They chopped his head off, right? And that's venerated. That was the first British martyr, St. Alban, 203 AD or 250 or whatever the date was. So that's Christ's teaching. If they strike you on one cheek, turn unto them the other cheek. That is the simple Christian teaching. Then the practicalities begin. That 41 million people in Ukraine, I sort of looked it up, and that by and large, you know, faith is Christian, mostly. Greek Orthodox, for some reason, I don't know why that is, but quite, you know, and they've been persecuted and so and so and so. So what? We turn the other cheek, do nothing. They're ratcheting up the sanctions now economically on Russia, but I gather it's Mother Russia, so it's very, you know, okay, so we'll suffer a bit of economic pain, so what? Sort of thing is the Russian kind of bottom line on that one. So with SWIFT, the big banking transfer thing, and you know, that'll hurt both ways, you know, trading. Actually, trade helps in not having wars. But this question of, do you respond to violence with violence? I've just spoken to some Aussie bloke, walked by. My own father fought on the Somme in the First World War, my mother's brothers in their kilts in the Second World War, and I, as it happens, was training to be a pilot through the Royal Air Force. None of this was there. Right, that's part of my background. Now, obviously, you, as Christ says, you try and look after women and children at the end times. Well, I don't think this is really the full end times, but it may well be a harbinger. And if you read the three passages in Matthew, Mark and Luke, not in John, which I've done many times, one of the harbingers of the end times are wars. Simple as that. And you stand firm. Well, all I can hear is birdies and the odd passing person passing, and motor cars driving and garage obviously open, the supermarket, Sunday, but there it is. So a peaceful scene, but we're under this nuclear umbrella still. There used to be CND was in the forefront, but campaign for nuclear disarmament. Cannon someone. Voice striker, is that right, maybe? And there was someone, Shepherd, with the Peace Pledge Union, so I used to go to Tavistock Square. Well, yes, try and avoid trouble, of course. So be prepared, but it's happening. And then the cycle repeats, doesn't it? The first world war to end, that's how it was described and seen, and look at us. Bigger and more bombs and weapons and everything. So the Western, purportedly Christian nations, mindset, spirit set is when push comes to shove, we will fight. The Queen is the supreme governor of the Church of England, but she's the head of the army too. So that's why I'm not a priest in the Church of England. That's why I'm here, alone, basically. Yeah, but what good am I, just alone praying? No, I will not fight. You could order me to the nth degree for whatever reason, I couldn't care less. No, is my answer, personally. Listen to Christ has to be the answer, however you perceive him to be. Amen. I like this old rock. Sorry. Oh, man with a rock on his head. Cheerio.